हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सीरीज ऑफ द लेक्चर्स फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ग्रुप थ्योरी। वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन ग्रुप थ्योरी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द वेरी बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट इन मैथमेटिक्स विच इज ऑफ फंक्शंस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट इज मीन बाय कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू सेट्स। इफ ए एंड बी आर टू नॉन एम्प्टी सेट्स, देन कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ऑफ सेट्स ए एंड बी is denoted by A cross B and is defined as A cross B is equal to set of all order pairs AB where A belongs to set A and B belongs to set B. That is, Cartesian product of two sets is nothing but the collection of all possible order pairs where first element of the order pair belongs to the first set of the Cartesian product and second element of the order pair belongs to the second element of the Cartesian product. Here, order of the elements is important. That is, first element must belongs to first set and second element must belongs to second set. That's why, in general, A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Because A cross B contains all the pairs of the form A, B, whereas B cross A is a set of all the order pairs such that first element belongs to set B and second element belongs to set A, that is of the form B, A. Now we will see how to find the Cartesian product using an example. Suppose A is a set of two elements 1 and 2 and B is a set of two elements 3 and 4. We will take here the simplest example. As we know, A cross B is set of all order pairs AB where A belongs to set A and B belongs to set B. Here, there are two possibilities for A, that is either A is equal to 1 or A is equal to 2. First, we will take A is equal to 1. Then for A is equal to 1, there are two possibilities of the second elements as B contains two elements. That is, either B is equal to 3 or B is equal to 4. So, we can pair first element with two elements. So, we will get here two pairs. 1, 3 and 1, 4. Similarly, if we take the second element of the first set, that is, A is equal to 2, then again, we can pair this element with two elements as set B contains two elements. That is, either B is equal to 3 or B is equal to 4. So, for A is equal to 2, again we get two pairs 2, 3 and 2, 4. So, here we have got A cross B is the collection of the pairs 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3 and 2, 4. So, to find the Cartesian product of the two sets, first we have to select the element from the first set one by one, then for each element of the first set we have to pair this element to the all possible elements from the second set. Here we will consider one note. Number of elements in the Cartesian product A cross B is equal to number of elements in the set A into number of elements in the set B. Concept of Cartesian product is useful to understand what is mean by function or operation. Suppose f is a function from set A to set B, where A and B are non-empty sets, then f is a subset of Cartesian product A cross B, such that for every element belongs to A, there exists exactly one image from B under f. That is, F is a subset of Cartesian product A cross B such that it contains the order pairs where every element of a set A is paired with exactly one element of the set B. We will try to understand this definition using example. Here we will take the simplest example. Set A contains 3 elements 1, 2, 3. B contains 3 elements 4, 5, 6. Then Cartesian product A cross B can be found by first taking the first element of the set A, that is 1, and pairing this element with the all possible elements of set B, that is 4, 5, 6. So we will get the pairs 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Then we will take the second element from set A, that is 2, and we will pair this with 4, 5, 6. We will get 2, 4, 2, 5, and 2, 6. Similarly, we will take the third element from set A, that is 3, and we will pair this element with all possible elements from set B, that is 4, 5, 6. We will get 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. So here we will get the in all 9 elements in the Cartesian product A cross B. Now, if we take the subset R is equal to 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 5. This is a subset of A cross B. Here we know that A is the set of 3 elements 1, 2, 3 and B is the set of 3 elements 4, 5, 6. Now we will check whether this is a function or not. Here, 1 belongs to set A and 4 belongs to set B. That is, 1 belongs to domain and 4 belongs to codomain. So, here 1 is paired with the 4, 2 is paired with the 5 and 3 is paired with the 5. So, here we can see every element of the set A is paired with exactly one element from the set B, as 1 is paired with 4, 2 is paired with 5 and 3 is paired with 5. So, this satisfies the definition of a function. So, subset R of A cross B is a function. Now, we will see one counter example to understand this concept. Consider a subset S which contains 4 order pairs 1, 4, 1, 6, 2, 5 and 3, 5. We know that A is the set of 3 elements 1, 2, 3 and B is the set of 3 elements 4, 5, 6. Here we can see 1 is paired with 4, that is 1 maps to 4. Again 1 is paired with 6. 2 is paired with 5 and 3 is paired with 5. Here we can see every element of the set A has image under F, but here 1 has 2 images, that is 1 is mapped to 2 elements. This contradicts to the condition that every element must have exactly one image, that is every element from set A must be paired with exactly one element from the set B. So S is not a function from A to B. Now we will consider next set T, that is of 1, 4 and 2, 5. So here 1 is paired with 4, 2 is paired with 5. These are only 2 elements in that set. So here 3 is not paired with any elements from set B. So this is again contradicts to the definition of function that every elements from the set A must have exactly one image from the set B. But here 3 does not have any image. That's why T is not a function from A to B. Now we will see summary of the lecture. Cartesian product of the two sets, set A and B, is denoted as A cross B and it is equal to set of all order pairs AB, where A belongs to set A and B belongs to set B. If F is a function from set A to set B, then F is a subset of Cartesian product A cross B such that for every A belongs to set A, there exists B belongs to set B such that order pair AB belongs to F, and AB1 belongs to F, AB2 belongs to F implies that B1 is equal to B2. In the next lecture, we will discuss upon the topics binary operation and one type of a binary operation, which is commutative operation. Thank you.